celebrate our centennial anniversary here at Portage Public Schools, a number of wonderful colleagues got together to really figure out what we truly value here. And the folks who worked on that were parents and students. They were teachers and leaders and community members, including some right here at Portage Central High School. They're going to walk you through what those values are as we look to our future.
We are working toward developing a set of values, an identity statement for our next 100 years at Portage Public Schools, and a definition of equity to guide our school district.
A team has developed a draft with your previous input from last school year, along with the input of parents, guardians, and caregivers, employees, and community members.
We want to show you the draft via a survey using a link that was sent to your school email and have you provide anonymous feedback to our development team on the draft values, identity statement, and equity definition.
Our team will use your feedback to finalize these values for the start of the next 100 years. The survey process does not include a discussion of the meaning of individual values or any single person's definition.
Thanks, folks, for filling out the survey, and now back to our regularly scheduled broadcasting.
Hey, Mustangs, I'm Hannah Huff.
And Ryan Canfield, here with your broadcast for the week of April 11th. Hey, Hannah, are you ready for your SAT?
Oh, you bet I am. Let's send it over to Lexi for more on SAT scheduling.
Hey, Mustangs, it's Lexi Lee here giving you your weekly school news. We have a weird schedule change this week with having the PSAT and SAT going on, as well as some more additional information on what to do. You can find more information on this if you go to the Junior Glick, Sophomore Glick, or Freshman Glick, where there is a page for SAT or PSAT information, which also has some tips for testing. Don't forget to bring your school ID, a number 2 pencil with a good eraser, and an approved calculator. Also, do not bring electronic devices, smart watches, highlighters, and a purse or a bag. That's all for this week, Mustangs. Good luck, and sending it back to Ryan and Hannah in the studio.
Thanks, Lexi.
Boy, last year my SAT was pretty rough. Some of those questions are pretty tricky.
Hey, speaking of tricks, let's send it over to Taylor for some unique pet tricks from some of your fellow Mustangs pets.
Hey Mustangs, it's Taylor here. Are you sick of seeing so many people on PCTV? Because so am I. Today, we will be showcasing some furry friends' talent.
Who let the dogs out?
Who let the dogs out?
Liza, come.
Good job. Now give me your other paw.
Well, the party was nice, the party was bumping. Hey, yeah. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started him calling. And the girls respond to the
jump.
Call. I have a poor white shot.
Who let the dogs jump. Out? Let's do it again. Shake.
Wow, those were some possum tricks from the cutest pups I've ever seen. That's it for this week, Mustangs. Have a great week. Back to Hannah and Ryan in the studio.
Oh man, that was so sick. You know, my dog can play lacrosse.
Really?
No, I lied. But let's send it over to Mason with an update on Mustang lacrosse teams.
Hey Mustangs, Mason Bell here with your athletic rundown for the week. Mother Nature clearly isn't ready to start our spring sports season, as the men's varsity golf match against Vicksburg was canceled, along with our women's varsity and JV softball games against Parchment due to rain. Luckily, our women's JV and varsity soccer teams got out to play at home against the Okemos Wolves, with our JV winning 3-1 and our women's varsity pulling off the Mercy with an 8-0 victory. That's all from me. Now off to Cole for more on lacrosse.
Thank you, Mason. The spring sports season has officially started, with many of the teams getting their first games out of the way already. One such being the Mustangs boys lacrosse and the Muskies women's lacrosse teams. Let's meet with some of our athletes to get an introduction into the lacrosse season.
I'm looking forward to just improving as a team and really getting that team chemistry down. We have a bunch of new players this year, so it's really exciting to see everyone just grow and improve throughout the season.
I'm looking forward to getting closer with my teammates.
Winning this year, because we didn't win that much last year, so getting some W's under the belt would be really nice.
I think as a team we can really improve upon our skills, and also I think it's really important to like help newer members, or just even just returning members. I think it's always good to like help support each other and just improve as a whole.
We can probably improve our communication and probably just get more guys in general.
basic handling skills. It'd be nice if we can figure out the basics before we try and get into all the specialties and stuff.
My goals for this season are to win most, if not all, of our games, and just to improve as a team and improve personally, because it's my senior year, so I just want to have a lot of fun too, and just have to form like new relationships with the people on the team.
Overall, our goal would probably be to be better than last year. Last year we had a tough year, so we're just trying to improve.
To go into playoffs.
Honestly, wins, but I really think the team can come together. I think it'd be nice to, you know, expand the lacrosse program.
Thanks, guys. That's all from me, and good luck to our LAC stars. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Mason. Wow, Ryan, you look really studious.
Yeah, I'm just brushing up on my literary knowledge for Battle of the Books.
Let's send it over to Emily Rose for some more information on fellow intellectuals like Ryan.
Hey Mustangs, it's Emily Rose, and this week is the announcement of a very exciting event, Battle of the Books. If you remember back in elementary school, some of you may have participated in this event before, and now we're bringing it back as a fun trivia event for students now. The event will be starting next Monday, April 18th, and go through the month of April to the end of May. So you have a whole month to prepare for the trivia competition at the end. Head on up to the library to sign up for your team and pick out the book you want to read. Let's flip the page to an interview with Lily Gearing.
You'll be put into teams of four and pick one book each, so if you want to sign up with friends, it is greatly encouraged. So I read my two books and I became kind of like the expert on that book and tried to encourage my team as much as I could to listen to me about what the answers would be for the questions for the trivia. Or there were like true and false questions, there were multiple choice questions. We often did a Kahoot, and that's how we did it. We took two teams from Portage Central and we versed each other to see who would go against Northern. And it was a nice little like friendly challenge and a rivalry that was kind of nice. It was nice to have that little like spark of rivalry of trying to beat the other team. Then we went against Northern. We unfortunately lost, but it was still really fun. So we're hoping this year to get back at them and win.
I am so excited to participate in the Battle of the Books this year. If you have more questions or want to sign up, please email Mrs. Brown at sbrown@portagepsat.org or Joshua Kim at joshua.kim@portagepsat.org. That's all from me. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Emily Rose. Make sure to get to reading, Mustangs.
I'm more of a music person than a reading person.
Me too. That's why I was so excited for the Grammys this year.
Let's send off to Britica for more information about this year's ceremony.
Hey Mustangs! Over the past few weeks, many award shows like the Grammys have taken place. From Olivia Rodrigo being nominated 7 times to Jon Batiste being nominated 11 times, we are going to see how people around PC feel about who should have really won which awards.
I don't think Olivia Rodrigo should have won because I don't think she's that good. I think there's a lot of other better artists out there who's had more successes than her. Just because she made one good song does not automatically mean she should be at the top.
Olivia Rodrigo did not deserve 7 nominations. She did good, but Baby Keem kind of deserved Best Artist because Olivia's pretty mid. I'm sorry. She's okay, but like, America Finds a New Teen Girl to obsess over, and their music is typically not even that good, so.
I think Lil Nas X should have won Artist of the Year for the Grammys.
I think Olivia Rodrigo deserved to win the Grammys that she did.
I definitely think Baby Keem should have won Best New Artist.
Thanks, guys. Now let's pass it back to Hannah and Ryan.
Thank you, Britica. I personally think Japanese Breakfast should have won Best New Artist, but I'm not surprised Olivia Rodrigo swept.
You kidding me? Baby Keem got snubbed. Well, that's all for this week. I'm Ryan Canfield.
And I'm Hannah Hoff.
Signing off.